And then basically after we're done with all this, let's say you have your cover, you have your graphic all done, and you have the cover done, you're ready to put this on your book and make a lot of money.
Yo, what's up guys? So in this video, I'm gonna teach you how to create a book cover with Affinity Publisher. And make sure you guys stay to the very end of this video. I'm gonna give you a little gift for you to download. And make sure you guys give this video a thumbs up.
Yo, what's going on? So right here, screen time tracker, right? So it's important to always start off with knowing how many pages you have in your interior, because we're going to use this and we're going to go to the KDP official website, Kindle Direct Publishing official website. And we're basically going to figure out the cover sizing, right? Basically, this video is going to help you show you guys how to get the correct template size for your cover. And this is very important because there's like, you can literally, I remember when I first started doing this, it took me like a week to get my first book up, right? And the most important thing is this, okay, look at the cover, how many pages we have. We have 150 pages in here, okay? I'm gonna show you exactly why right now. So for that example, the trim size on that one is an 8x10 and 150 page count. Now, depending on the paper color, right? Whatever, cream color, white, we'll use white for this example. But this is always gonna be different because sometimes you'll create a book and it'll be 145 pages, all right? Or for this example, it'll be 150 pages. So always remember that when you upload a new book, you don't wanna run into any type of issue. So we'll go ahead and download that. I'll put this link down below in the description. And then as you come over here too as well, I'll put this one down below too as well. But it's gonna give you an understanding exactly what we're gonna go over right now. So just stay to the end of this video. I'll give you that interior for free too as well. It's important that you just follow along with this, right? So I am going to go ahead and open this real fast. Extract. Boom. Okay, cool. And basically what we just downloaded the cover template, right? And now we're going to come over here to Affinity Publisher and come back here. I'm going to pop the cover. Here's the PNG size, and I can actually upload that into Affinity Publisher right now too, but this is what we're gonna do. So this can be a little bit confusing. I made a previous video about this with PowerPoint and then with Canva too as well. It still works to this day. So what we're going to do is we're gonna look at this right here, right? So as you can see, our spine is 8 or 0.34, right? And then there's a bleed on each side. So basically, and then the page, so front and back. So front is gonna be 8 inches plus 0.125. That's the bleed for the front cover, right? Plus the back cover would be 8 plus 8.15 equals, so that's what we're getting, 16.25. But we are forgetting the spine. So we gotta go over here to the spine. Plus 0.34. And you're like, why are you doing this for? So I'm gonna show you right now. Should have did this one first, but it's okay. We're still gonna get it right. So we're looking at this, the page width, right? So we got it correct over here with the calculator. So basically what we did was front page, bleed, spine, front page, bleed, right? And we got 16, which is gonna be the 16.59. So 16.59, right? Boom. Now the height. All right, so now we're just going to come over here. So it's 10, right? 10 plus 1.25, is that? Plus 0.125. We got 10.25. All right, now the DPI, everything. Facing pages, turn that off. And then we don't need none of that because we have everything all configured right here. Right, and literally you just save this template, right? Okay, and then you just press create, right? And then also too, you can, so we have that PNG file, right? You want to see if it, right, boom, boom, click there, and then of course we want to center the bad boy, right? Came over to the alignment, I just center it exactly. Just to make sure that if we, when we zoom in too, just like, look, you know what I mean? Look at it, perfect, boom. Oh, did I move it? Yes, I did. Real simple, beep. Right, now this is the correct size right here. As you guys can see, pretty much done, right? But now the part is you can start designing, right? Real simple. Also too, you just click that off right there and make it disappear. Or that Audacity thing, come over here, this tool, let me see, oop, click that. And then as you're doing all this cool stuff, you can, like, you know, just in case, like, you want to see you're not inside of the red marks right here, because it says not to put any designs right here. You can kind of just make it fade out, right? And then you can put, like, the text of the cover and all that fun stuff right there. And this is really, really, really cool. All right, so I just added some little text right here. Now, as you can see, it's not anywhere covered near the red part right here, because this is important too, because if you guys get it, like, close to the red part right here, it's going to basically reject the book cover. So as you start to do this, so let me just take that off right there. You're gonna see how we have it right there, and I'll just put it on there for the test video. And then basically after we're done with all this, let's say you have your cover, you have your graphic all done, and you have the cover done, you're ready to put this on your book, right? So now we're gonna just file, exports, and then we're PDF, and then make sure you click PDF for print, 300 DPI, export, test video. And also too, guys, I'm not no designer. I suck at designing, by the way. I outsource. I'm a big fan of outsourcing. So I do have a team when it comes to design work and all that stuff, just to be very transparent. So we're going to come back over here to the KDP actual dashboard. So we're going to come over here, 8x10. It's good, good, good. I'm going to upload that interior that I showed you guys, and it's going to be down below in the description if you want it. Look. Boom, boom. Launch. All right, guys. Also, you guys are going to see that I changed the color of the background. It's because I put it white and you couldn't see if we, like, zoomed in, if it fit correctly. And obviously it does. So you guys see how I got the correct margins around the outside and the border. So basically this book's good to go. Of course, change the cover, you know, design for the interior. And you see we switched the pages. Boom, boom, done. Press approve, go on to the pricing and make a lot of money, right? I wish it was that easy, but it's not that easy. Yeah, of course, the cover is one of the most important parts when you're designing covers. It's just as important as the interior. But for this example, I just wanted to show you guys how to create the actual template size, so you can actually get the correct size. And that's one of the most important parts, the correct size for your cover, right? Because it's a lot of people run into this error, right? They reach out to me all the time. I can't upload my book because my cover is wrong. The dimensions are wrong. And literally just right there, exactly how I showed you is how you actually do that the correct way. And you can pretty much apply it to any single size or dimension or number of pages, but each book, whatever interior is different, of course, but you want to make sure you have the page correctly and plug it into the KDP template. And it's going to give you, remember, the spine is different, you know, and then you got to take into consideration of the size and all that stuff. So yeah. And also too, guys, if you guys are unaware, I have an interior service business, Pixel Pod Studio, and I'll put that down below. Come up with 10 interiors a month, research niches, all research niches, all new niches every single month, new niches, 10 a month, research keywords. Okay. And then also two custom line drawings for each niche. So these templates are already, they're good. Sizing, everything's correct. They're also available in InDesign, PowerPoint, Affinity Publisher, we just added. And yeah, that's it. I hope you guys enjoy this video. Peace out.